Good morning and welcome back to Laem Chabang. This is my 14th and last round here. After this, I will never set foot on Jack's masterpiece ever again. I've got so many memories here. The Mountain Nine is my favourite, but we're not playing that today. In fact, out of the 14 rounds, I've only played it 5 times. Now it's windy. This is unusual for Thailand at this time of year. You don't tend to get a bit of wind. So there's a few bad shots in this round, or rather short shots, from not getting the wind correct. But look at this, blue sky, a cheerful caddy, a lot of fun, nobody to distract me. What more could you possibly ask for? I have actually parred all 3 nines here from time to time. I've never managed to par 2 nines in the same round though. I've never managed that magic 72. Now, one thing I don't like here is the sleeve they put on top of the cup. What it means is that you've got a hard plastic surface as opposed to soft soil. So sometimes, or most of the time, they will lip out rather than lip in.
Left a bit. Keep going left.
Whoa. Okay, come
on. Yay! It's about time I got a birdie on this hole.
Back to par.
One of my memories is playing with 3 Japanese golfers. They were complete beginners, so they were playing that game that a lot of beginners play, which is bingo bango bongo, and they were exceptionally loud about it. They had no idea about etiquette, so they were putting me off. I was 4 over after 7 holes. Do you know what? This is one shot I really hate in Thailand. It's the downhill down grain, and you've got to hit it so softly that it all goes wrong. So I had a 12-foot birdie putt on 8 and I missed it, and I obviously was feeling a bit down to be paired with these 3 guys who were making a hell of a lot of noise on tee boxes and greens and poring over the card to see who had the most points so far. And my caddy, Apple, whose photograph will appear at the end of this video, we came off the 8th and she dragged me very quickly to the 9th tee and told me to concentrate through it and not give up. And that was the first time I shot level par round Valley. But from the 9th on Lake, this 9, the par 5 up the hill, until closing out on the 18th green, I managed 10 pars. All my thanks have got to go to Apple for putting me in the right frame of mind to concentrate through it. Another round of golf here. I was playing with a Yorkshireman and 2 Australians. The Yorkshireman was an 8 handicap and he was desperate to beat me on that tour. He'd completely failed up to that point. We played this 9 here, and I was a little bit ropey. In fact, I shot 40 to his 39. In the drink stop at the start of Valley, he was very full of himself.
Wow.
My caddy dragged me to one side, caddy number 9, I forget her name, and she just said, "Slow down, you're swinging much too fast." What good advice for all of us at any time. Don't you find it ironic that the one time I hit the fairway, I make a bogey? Par 3 again, I've yet to hit this green on this tour. And we miss it a third time. 3 out of 3, that's not bad. Anyway, we teed off on the Valley 9. With my caddy's help, I added a 37 to my outgoing 40. Almost, Simon, almost, to finish with 77. But what of my Yorkshire opponent? Well, in the first 4 holes of the Valley 9, he put 7 balls in the water, and he blew up to a 62. And then he forgot all about his bet. That was something he was very good at, was forgetting his bets when he lost. And he lost every single bet in 2 weeks with me. Silly boy. Yeah, we did finish up dry. We're going straight for the flag. I should be able to make this today. And this is what I was laughing about. Now I've got plenty of room, and the more room I've got to play my short game, the better chance I have of being successful. And it really isn't very often that I actually get a par chance on Jack's signature hole.
Hard enough. Inside left.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, after 14 rounds here, I do an awful lot of putting on memory. The caddies just told me, shadow flag. So I'm going to hit this at the end of the shadow. This is what good caddies are like. They save you an absolute ton of shots. And you've just got to love them to pieces. So my ball's down there in the fairway, by that tree. I'm playing up the hill, but I've got the wind behind me. I've got to come over this mound in front of the green with the tree and the rocks. There's a flag in it which tells you where the flag is on the green because you can't see the green. And there's the green itself. Now I've tried this before and failed, I hit the tree. But as this is my last round, I'm giving this one the berries. Well, I'm inbounds by quite a bit, as it happens, I'm only just over the cart path. But this is a high tariff shot, I really should consider hitting an iron. A short iron, as opposed to my 4-iron.
Pretty good.
But hitting a short iron is not going to get the job done today. I'm out for blood. And I'm going to do everything I can to get
bad.
It.
Inside left. Medium. Little bit up.
Wait.
I don't mind saying I'm absolutely hopeless in fairway bunkers, but this is only 53 yards. The closer I get, the better I get. This is uphill, it's into the grain, I can hit this firm, and it's gonna stop on a sixpence. We haven't had rain for a week and a half, so everything is drying out. The ball is running. I'm getting more or less the same distance as I get at home, 250 to 265, depending on strike. So a little bit of rough. I saved my bacon with that fairway sloping left to right. We can go ahead and make a par on one of the hardest holes. I know. To have a fairway that tight and then having to come over water with your second and then a very slopey green, it's a damn good job. I've got a good caddy today. Another one of those chips where you're chipping up onto a downslope that's down grain. One day I'll figure out how to actually play these, but then again, this is my last trip, so I probably won't. you cannot beat having a great caddy. Now my favourite par 3 on the course. It's a 4-iron today, back into the breeze. And I'm still fighting my god-awful grip. Now I've got no choice to play a shot that I never practice. Open up the sand wedge. Throw this into the sky. And basically hope for the best. It really isn't my long suit. And I almost hold it.
Nice par. Oh no, not bunker, not bunker.
Well, obviously, right. Is no good with all those bunkers, and now you can see the tree in the middle of the fairway. From where I am here, instead of hitting a mid-iron, it's a 5-wood. Straight over the top. And left again. So I'm faced with yet another one of those. Open the face of the sand wedge and throw the ball into the sky. That's pretty decent for a shot that I never, ever practice. Very windy now. I'll tell you what would be nice. Just for a change, I can hit this at the left-hand bunker and fade it round into the widest part of the fairway. Thank goodness for that. I wouldn't want to finish my career, if you like, at Laem Chabang without hitting this fairway one last time. I can't believe it's all over, to be honest. It's been going on for 15 years. Every now and then, I have the money to go. And it's bittersweet. I'm playing, or rather scoring well. But at the same time, there's an awful lot of sadness. I think I'll try an 8-iron today and not go in that back bunker. My caddy's just given me the line, and she's told me that it's easy, this putt. Okay, it's easy. But let's see how easy it is when I'm caddying for you, and you have a go. Although my putter's a good foot too long for her, it's quite funny.
Longer putt back there.
Ah! my 252nd hole at Laem Chabang. Cheerio. I'm never going to be back.
Bad.